finally get it. This is my app. Let's see what my app is doing. Let's say if I pick English, then my nav bar here will show English. If I pick Japanese, then it shows Japanese. Let's see Chinese. Then you see Chinese here. Now let's see the display area, which is this part here. Just go back. Actually, this can be command out. Save it. Now it's gone. Switch it back to English. The trick here is the sidebar, which is this area. Here you see the column table display. Let me Window E show you in Excel. Now you see the table file. Inside PYBKP - bookkeeping folder, this table CSV file contains all the settings. Here I create a table variable with the display column. It's just like adding the display column here. The display column will be based on the select language, which is this language code ENG JAP CHI. Here we don't need to add anything to the CSV. Instead, we add it through the Python script. That's why we do nothing to the CSV file. For the table display, I call the getTable function, which is defined above. This will return the table based on the CSV file I just showed. This language select area is the selected reporting language. Here I slice the first three characters. In this case, it is ENG. When I pick Japanese, this will be JAP, Chinese CHI, and it applies to the whole table display column that we mentioned before. Before that, I didn't include to list in my code inside the option menu. Take it out and save, and it'll be like this. I don't know why. Pretty strange, isn't it? But if I go back to the sidebar and table display, which is based on the select language, returns the language description. Here I add the toList function, save it. Then the navbar language display is done properly. Let me add an index. Let me see what to do. Just put in some text and you'll see index here. The index should be the table reference, this part. Then we can search other stuff with the reference within this column. That's it for today. Alright, bye.